So how to improve your improvisational dancing skills? It's a little bit hard because, you know, if you're there, music, dancing, and there's an audience, it's a show. So it's hard to recreate that type of a situation fully. And that being said, one of the best ways, I think, to improve your skills is take advantage of opportunities that come to you, particularly opportunities to dance to live music. Even if you don't feel 100% ready, I never feel 100% ready, even now. Don't torture yourself, but if you're like 75% ready, you know what? Take the plunge. Don't be too hard on yourself. Go out, do the best you can, because you have to experience it. Real improvisational dancing, and generally I define that as being with live music, you just have to kind of throw yourself in and see what happens, and just be tolerant with yourself and be accepting of that. But anyway, trying to come up with a practice in your own home to improve your improvisational skills. Yes, I have a process. It's a long process. Get your pen and get your paper, because I love long processes. You're going to start by making a playlist, and make a deep playlist, so you don't have to do this very often because it's time consuming. In your playlist, do not put your favorite songs, songs that you love that you're going to want to dance to, songs that maybe you're already dancing to. Don't put them in the playlist, because what you want in the playlist is songs you are not familiar with. So you love 3 songs on an album, you take the other 6 and put them in the playlist. Unfamiliar. The whole point of really developing your improv skills is that you go out there, you have no idea what you're going to hear, and you deal with it, and you dance to it, and you sell it. And that's why we need to have unfamiliar music. I suggest, too, a diversity of music. You want lyrical, you want percussive. Other than that, it's going to be up to you, because maybe you know that you're going to be dancing only to modern Arabic music, or you know it's all going to be American cabaret style. So obviously, you know, put what you need in there, but I still say diversity. The challenge in this is being able to dance to anything. That's really the challenge. If you are trying to train yourself for shows, for a full-length show, then obviously you're going to need to build full-length shows and put them in there. Because part of that is physical pacing, is getting used to sustaining for 20 minutes, 30 minutes a show. So anyway, we have our playlist built. We're going to add one more element to this playlist. One song, or just a couple of songs, regular, simple songs, not dance songs. These should be more like warm-up music, kind of relaxing, meditative. These are going to be, it can be one or it can be several, a transitional song. You know, we don't go from doing the laundry to performing. There's a transformational process. There's a transition. You take your shower, put on your makeup, grab the gig bag, get to the venue. So we don't want to just try and dive right in and be into dancer mode. This is going to be our gateway song. During this transitional song, all you're going to do is just beautiful dance walk, calm around your dance space, get your breathing nice, relax, get into your performance mode, get into your performance head. And I highly suggest, take this opportunity, here's the chance to run a little mental checklist. Are my shoulders down? Is my chest lifted? Is my core engaged? Are my knees soft? Are my hands relaxed? Whatever your mental checklist needs to be, run through it now. Because when you're out there improvising, at least if you're like me, I have no brain power left over to be worried about these things. You have to get these bodily characteristics absorbed so that you can, that they just become part of you. But that little reminder right before you go out on stage is actually very helpful. And you can keep this practice, because there's always going to be those few minutes before you're actually performing. And you can run through the same checklist in your head. So this is the main part of the process. You've got your transitional piece, you have your music that you're going to actually dance to. Once you're into that music that you're dancing to, you don't stop. This is a show. And this is it. You cannot stop. You have to go all the way through the piece. If something goes wrong, how would you cover it if there was an audience? And this leads me to a wonderful tip given to me by the fabulous Gamila El Masri, and it sounds goofy, but it really, really works. Build yourself a faux audience. It can be stuffed animals, it can be dolls. What I think really works well is just rip faces out of magazines. Put them on the wall, put them on the mirror, wherever your dance space is, so that you have a focus. Part of what makes dancing, I think, rather unnerving, again, at least for me, it's these eyes on you. Who are these people, these strangers looking at you? You need to get used to that. And as silly as it sounds, looking at fake people, you do start to get accustomed to the idea that someone is looking back at you. And you need to get used to looking at them. You need to have a focused gaze. You don't want your energy going to the floor or this kind of amorphous all over the room and it doesn't ever land anywhere. You get used to looking at those people. You know, you don't have to look them right in the eye. You look at the center of the forehead, you look over their head, but sending your energy to the audience. And it's very helpful. And if something goes wrong while you're practicing, give them a bigger smile, make a little move, develop a kind of a saving grace movement for yourself. The more you do that, then if it happens while you're out there dancing live, you're just going to be conditioned. It's going to become kind of a reflex. So having the fake audience, very, very helpful. Another tactic you can employ, if you're really, really determined to improve yourself, is to videotape yourself. Put that camera in with your fake audience, and that will really help you to see, are you truly projecting energy and emotion to your audience? Because sometimes we think we're calm, we're relaxed, we're happy, and we don't realize, especially when we're beginning as dancers, we're not really projecting yet. We maybe have achieved a neutral face. We don't necessarily look stressed, but we're a little distant. We're not really reaching the audience. So this is going to help you put that energy out there.
I don't really do a lot of improvisation. I mostly only improvise if I have to improvise. And if I have to improvise, I can do it. It's cool. I'm prepared. And I don't mind improvising, but I'm not particularly oriented towards improvisation. It's not just about dance, it's about me. It's my personality in general, is that I feel like if there's anything that's important to me, I like to do a lot of preparation. So that's just where I come from. My experience with dance was that it was very, very hard to learn to improvise. I know some people walk straight into it, and I think that's a thing that's just about personality type. For me, it took a few years, several years. The first few times I tried to do it, I would just stand there and go, I had no idea what to do. And the reason that I had no idea what to do is that I had no sense of ownership of my dance vocabulary. Now I've choreographed 1,000 dances, so I have so much practice in transitioning from every possible move into every other possible move that all of these things are very deeply in my body, and they're things that I really own. But if you ask me to do that after I've been taking class for 6 months or a year, I couldn't even stand there and really do a hip lift in time with music. I mean, I could do that as a drill, but I knew that that was a drill, not dancing. I couldn't do anything. It was terrible. So I guess my tips for improvisation are probably most useful for people who, like me, come to it with a lot of inhibition or trepidation. And this is maybe not the advice that people want to hear, but the only good advice that I have is just to stick with it. And it might really, really take a long time. It could take a long time. And if you just can't improvise at all, go ahead and choreograph. Choreograph stuff for years and years and years and years and years until you can choreograph a complete dance the first time exactly the way you want it. And then what do you know? You just improvised. So I think that's my best advice. Thank you.